September 2006. The QuickBird 2 satellite is orbiting over the Canadian wilderness when it captures an image of giant worm-like shapes emerging from the forest.
It really looks like some writhing mass of white worms. There's no obvious beginning or end. Just how big are they?
It doesn't show anything that makes any logical sense.
What could have formed these strange shapes?
The image was captured 4 miles east of the isolated town of Dawson City in Yukon Territory, Canada. Ground-level inspection of the site reveals the worm-like shapes seen from space are massive piles of rock and gravel. The answer to the mystery of the snaking heaps of rock could lie further back in Dawson City's turbulent history.
In 1896, in a river valley, they found gold.
The start of the Klondike Gold Rush was a phenomenon never before seen by man. There was so much fevered pitch excitement. People coming up here looking for gold, expecting more than they found, and some found more than they expected.
The Klondike was absolute Wild West. It's dangerous, but you can make your fortune.
But the sheer size of these massive piles of rubble rules out the possibility they were made by lone prospectors chasing a dream of gold.
We're not talking about panning for gold in a stream here. To leave behind huge piles of gravel like this would require a monster machine.
This is gold mining in a huge industrial scale.
The satellite image contains the key to the mystery. Close to the gravel piles is a large rectangular structure. What looks like a building is revealed at ground level to be a vast mobile gold dredge standing 8 stories high.
Dredge number 4 is like a giant gold pan on a floating barge where it picks up the gold-bearing gravels, it sorts them with water, the gold would settle in the bottom, and the waste would go out the back.
You can gouge out enormous quantities of earth with trucks that are the size of houses, extracting gold from huge piles of material, and then dump the remnants, which are called the tailings. It generates piles of material on the surface that are hundreds of feet long and many tens of feet high.
The massive dredging machines would move along digging out the earth, extracting the gold, and then leave a long pile of leftover rubble behind them, creating the worm-like shapes.